Welcome everyone to an extraordinary opportunity. That is, today is this great opportunity to give up simply spending your time idly, which is all that we're doing. When we're seeking to change identity, we are simply doing nothing at all. And the truth is that for all this time that we've been trying to really uncreate creation, we've been doing absolutely nothing. So it's today we can give up that effort to keep doing nothing. All attributes of identity are omnipresent and unchangeable. Identity is totally non-relative. It is omnipresence. There's only one identity. It's omnipresent. All attributes of identity are omnipresent. Totally unchangeable. We need do nothing. We did not create identity. So there's nothing we need to do to find identity, to establish identity. Absolutely nothing we need to do. We've been trying to change identity, change what God created. It's impossible. So we're just in this like dream-like sleep, but where nothing is taking place actually. Now, I'm in this titanic struggle to stop doing nothing. And every day, it's like an archaeological dig. You keep finding new layers down below. You know, there's one civilization, one layer. Then you go down to there's another civilization, and then you go deeper, still another. It's like, wow. Just a constellation of extreme resistance. This morning, when I woke up from sleep. When we're seeking for identity, we're just sleeping. Identity never sleeps. It's always awake. Identity never falls asleep. Never. Never, never, never. What is omnipresent can never be asleep to what it is. There's no place it can go where it is not. When we seek to change identity, we seem to fall into the sleep of unawareness. And what I've discovered is when you engage in sanity, you get nowhere. So the only way to really awaken to what can never fall asleep is to do affirmations and declarations of fact instead of engaging in insanity, madness. So the struggle is to not engage madness. That's the whole struggle of the spiritual path. And to the extent that we engage it, we're just spinning our wheels. What is totally mad, you cannot get anywhere with it. It's like we need to defund the ego at its root. As long as we're funding its root, we will be struggling, trying to prune all the different branches and shoots that keep coming off. There's no end to it. So we spend a whole day desperately pruning. We wake up the next morning, and there's all this new growth. And we spend our whole life doing that. What we have to do is defund the root of the ego. And we do that by simply stating truth. That defunds it. And then the root vanishes. And when the root vanishes, all the shoots that the root's putting up, those are gone too. So that's the real spiritual path. And we get tired of failure and doing nothing. So eventually we have to turn towards actually stating truth. And it's a tremendous battle for me going on in my mind right now. The ego is trying to, you know, try to be resurgent and twist things backwards. And I say, no. So The ego wants us to be lazy and fall asleep and say, oh, I'm tired, I can't do it, this and that. And we have to say, no. That's the whole struggle. So help is to coach everyone to declare truth. Just declare truth. Not in a robotic way or a ritualistic way, but in an actual conscious way. Consciously apply it. You have your consciousness there. Don't be just saying something your mind is like drifting off thinking about the day and you're just mouthing the words. That doesn't work. It doesn't work. So it's like getting up in the morning and like digging a pit or a hole. You're digging. It's hard work. It's not easy work. I've been battling this morning, just terrific battle. Oh man. But that's what has to be done. So there is no relative identity. There's only one identity that is omnipresent. There is no relative identity. There's only one identity and not a second. One identity without a second. I need not seek what can never be lost. I need not seek what can never be lost. I need not seek what can never be lost. What can never be lost need not be found. What can never be lost need not be found. I need not seek to find what can never be lost. Merely by giving up the seeking complex, the seeking and finding complex, identity stands revealed. What is stands revealed. All attributes of identity are omnipresent. All attributes of identity are omnipresent and can never be changed. All attributes of identity are identity. We did not create identity. All attributes of identity are effortlessly present, are omnipresent. Identity is omnipresent. It is omnipresence. That is the one identity. All attributes of omnipresence are omnipresent. There is no other identity. There is no other identity. Only identity has value. Only identity has value. Seeking nothing has no value. Seeking nothing has no value. Only identity has value. I choose the one identity. The one identity is what I truly want to experience. The one identity is the great good news. All attributes of the one identity are present to be experienced. Are always present. So this is how we start to get into practice. It doesn't start out nice and crisp and fresh. It's a struggle. Really, don't be afraid of the struggle, because it is a titanic struggle to turn this around. Do not engage the ego. Simply state truth. This is the way for sure. And you can easily tell the difference when you're stating truth. You feel that you're succeeding. And when you're engaging the ego, you feel desperately like you're wasting your time somehow. And it's a terrible feeling. The one identity is totally non-relative. The one identity is totally non-relative. This is what we're getting at. And the ego will furiously try to block your way. And for instance, this morning I had all these dreams of opportunities to be a hero. And I said, wow, very scary. I said, no. and trying to cause that complex, the hero complex, to flee. So don't engage it directly. Don't try to work with it for some deal. No deals. No deals. There are no deals with identity. There are no deals to strike with identity. There are no deals to strike with identity. There are no deals to strike with omnipresence. There are no deals to strike with omnipresence. There are no deals with truth. There are no deals to make with truth. There are no deals to make with truth. I need not waste time in such a manner. So, truth is true. There is no deal to it. It's always true. It's omni-true. Truth is always present everywhere. Truth is always present everywhere. That's not a deal, that's reality. I seek not a deal, but reality. A deal, all deals have no value. All deals have no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Deals have no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. The vision of oneness is the undoing of all attachment to all deals. It's the realization that we don't need any deals. It's the realization that deals are totally unnecessary and really nothing at all. But we need this realization. We cannot just jump into pure knowing because of the continuity problem. So what we do is we take the soft landing of realization. Realization is the soft landing. Vision of oneness is the soft landing. It's realization. The dawning of this realization is this dawning. But it's not the direct knowing. We don't jump into direct knowing because we have a severe continuity problem. So we take the soft landing of the vision of oneness. That's it. The soft landing of the oneness is realization. The realization of the omnipresent one identity, the non-relative identity. It's the realization of that. It's not a deal, it's a realization of it. See, it's not a deal, it's a realization. Deals have no value, only the realization of the vision of oneness has value. So do not work on the situation on the ego's terms. The ego tries to get you to use its terminology. What we're doing here is we're using the terminology that the Holy Spirit suggests to us. This is all important. As long as we're using the terminology of the ego and the phrasing of it, we are going to be severely confused like a split mind, and we'll be trying desperately to integrate, and we'll just be in such anguish. It's absolutely necessary to use the terminology that the Holy Spirit suggests and to use it conceptually, to phrase it the way the Holy Spirit suggests, because this attunes us to realization of the vision of oneness. It attunes us in that direction. The ego is always suggesting this. Do you mean this? Or do you, it's trying to put it back into its conceptual framework, the ego, always. This is what you must resist. That's why I'm saying do not engage the ego. Do not engage it. Simply continue to use the right terminology, the right frameworks that the Holy Spirit suggests, the right spiritual practice. And that is what causes the ego to flee, these complexes to flee. When you refuse to engage it, it flees. Because it says, from its standpoint, it says, this is total madness. There's nothing to engage with here. I gotta go. You're defunding it by not refusing to engage it. So, real spiritual practice is the insistence on only using the terminology and the phrasing and the focus that the Holy Spirit is suggesting, and not trying to do both, but not a deal. There's no deal here. The ego says, well, let's make a deal. No, there's no deal. No deal to be made. And the ego says, well, I can't hang around then. Good. Goodbye. Don't hang around. So the ego will flee. Your job is to not flee with it. So that's why the mood of repentance is the fundamental base of all spiritual practice, is this non-fleeing determination, sobriety, calmness, patience, determination, humility. As you're saying, I will sit here in this mood of repentance, which is non-combative, non-reactive, non-argumentative, non-deal-making. Okay, we call it the non-deal-making mood. That's another great way to put it. So the ego will be desperately trying to leave the video, leave the room, leave the practice, leave whatever you're doing, your right focus. And you just have to remain seated, practicing, focused where you are, and let the ego go. Don't let it take your body with it. Okay, your body remains where it is. Your mind remains where it is. The ego leaves, and you don't go with it. So this no-deal mood, this no-fleeing, no-deal mood, is vitally important. Because the ego will flee, for sure. It will want to leave when it's hearing this terminology like this. It says, I gotta go. This is no deal here. See, the ego knows what it's trying to do is impossible. So, what it wants is a deal. Actually, what it wants to do is buy time. It has no choice but to try to accomplish the impossible. So realizing that it can't succeed, it pushes its success into the future, and then it needs to buy time for the future. It needs to buy time for there to be a future, meaning future futility. So it tries to strike a deal with truth, saying, look, truth, just don't be truth now. Be truth later. So, of course, what's that? The future, buying time. The ego's always trying to buy time. What we have to do is refuse to engage the ego in its efforts to make a deal and continue to state truth. The truth is true right now. Truth is true right now and always is true. Truth is true. Truth is always true. Truth is true right now. Truth is always true. The one identity is now. The one identity without a second is right now. The one identity without a second identity, without any deals, is right now. There is no deal to now. There is no deal to now. There is no deal to now. Now is now. Now is now. The one identity is now. Omnipresence is now. There is no deal to omnipresence. Omnipresence is now. All attributes of omnipresence are now. All attributes of omnipresence are fully present right now, just as it is. This time, this day, just as it is, is fully present. fully present right now. This day, just as it is the day of omnipresence. This plant, just as it is the plant of omnipresence. So, trying to shift it into specific practice from a generalized, more generalized viewpoint. So sometimes this is a little difficult to do. All identity The one identity includes this plant just as it is right now. There's a definite shift when you try to go into this sort of specific practicing. It feels like there's a shift there. There's a little like a feeling of slight discontinuity from just speaking abstractly. Cannot go into mindless practice where consciousness is not aware of what we're doing. We have to bring, the meaning with it. This tree is the fullness of this tree, just as it is the fullness of all attributes of the one identity. This plant, as it is the fullness of all unchanging attributes of the one identity. This table, as it is the fullness of all unchanging attributes of the one identity. That rock edging, as it is the fullness of all attributes of the one identity. This place, as it is the fullness of all attributes of the one identity. This plant, as it is the effortless expression of the one identity. That tree, as it is the effortless expression of all identity. That wall, as it is the effortless expression of the omnipresent identity. That bird, as it is the effortless expression of the omnipresent identity. That hedge, as it is the effortless expression of the one identity. All attributes of the one omnipresent identity are effortlessly expressed in that hedge, just as it is. All attributes of the omnipresent one identity are effortlessly being expressed as that wall, just as it is. All attributes of the omnipresent one identity are effortlessly being expressed as that car, just as it is. All attributes of the all-inclusive omnipresent one identity are effortlessly being expressed as that walkway, just as it is. That walkway, just as it is the effortless expression of all attributes of the one all-inclusive, omnipresent identity. The all attributes of the omnipresent, all-inclusive, one identity are effortlessly being expressed as that flower, just as it is. That flower, just as it is the effortless expression of the all-inclusive, omnipresent identity. That one flower, just as it is the effortless expression of all attributes of the omnipresent, all-inclusive, one identity. So, doing this practice now is what is defunding the ego at its root. It's defunding it. The effortless and omnipresent, the all attributes of the effortless and omnipresent, all-inclusive, one identity are effortlessly expressed as this plant, just as it is. This plant, just as it is the effortless expression of all attributes of the all-inclusive, omnipresent identity. This table, just as it is the effortless expression of all attributes of the all-inclusive, omnipresent one identity. That stonework, just as it is the effortless expression of all attributes of the all-inclusive, omnipresent, one identity. All attributes of the omnipresent, totally inclusive, one identity are effortlessly expressed as that mat, just as it is. That mat, just as it is the effortless expression of all attributes of the totally inclusive, omnipresent, one identity. See, we're simply stating truth here, instead of thinking about it, instead of trying to battle the ego, well, which terminology is better, this or that, and trying to, no, we have our terminology. We have our practice. We're simply practicing. That tree, just as it is the effortless expression of the presence of all attributes of the totally inclusive, omnipresent, one identity without a second. The all attributes of the omnipresent, all-inclusive, one identity is effortlessly being expressed as that tree, just as it is. all unchanging attributes, all the unchanging attributes, all attributes which are totally unchanging, which are totally unchangeable, the unchangeable attributes of the totally inclusive and omnipresent one identity are effortlessly being expressed as that dirt, just as it is. That dirt, just as it is the effortless expression of the unchangeable attributes of the all-inclusive, omnipresent, one identity. So when we practice, we only use the verbiage of the one truth, of truth, the one identity. You do not mix, try to mix and mingle, you know, the concepts, the verbiage, the structure of all of that. That's what causes us to feel very, very, on very shaky ground. Because then we think we need to make a deal. And how do you make a deal with madness? Time, you say, time. The ego says, I need time to make this deal. You're not making a right deal with me, I need some time. And so all this time we're spending is just, we're struggling to make a deal. You know, what's the deal? Can we make a deal today? Can we make a deal now? How much time do you need? How much time do you need? That's all the ego, all we're talking about is how much time do you need, ego? How much time do you need? Now that's too much time. It's a battle over time, of how much time the ego, we're going to give the ego. And we never want to give it as much as it asks for. And so it's always asking for more. We're always pulling back, saying, now wait a minute, how do you justify that? And then you get into this whole justification talk. It's trying to justify to you why it wants time. And you're trying to justify to the ego why you don't want to give it that much time. And this then is this all this dialogue, all this stuff in your mind that just completely causes you this anguish and feeling that you're not really getting anywhere, and you think you're getting somewhere if you think that you're able to get the ego to ask for a little less. But it doesn't really ask for less. What it says is, I'm listening to your justification a little bit here, so if you can just justify your insistence on less time, I'm open to that, but I need the justification. And so then you're totally caught up in justification, trying to justify your position. Truth doesn't need to justify itself. Omnipresence doesn't need to justify itself. There's nothing to justify itself to. Why do we need to justify ourselves to nothing? Why do we need to justify the non-relative identity to nothing? So what the ego is saying is that it can justify its position if you just give it a little more time. But what is unjustifiable? Nothing has no justification. There is no, so we don't need to give the ego any time. It's a complete waste of time. Time is a waste of time because there's nothing to justify. Relativity is not identity. Has nothing to do with identity. It's just a waste of time. Seeking identity where it is not. Seeking identity where it is not is a complete waste of time because it's everywhere. So we've just invented this whimsical notion that identity has something to do with relative location. It has nothing to do with relative location. Or we say it has something to do with labels. Has nothing to do with labels. But because we have a continuity problem with location and labels, so our practice is to use location and labels, but to then insist that this too is the one identity. So we say that plant just as it is. So that's a location and a label, right? Okay, so we have a drastic continuity problem. Therefore, we must practice it. When we are discussing a deal with the ego, we're not practicing, for sure. And I can testify to this. I spent my life not practicing, instead arguing with the ego over how much time is justified, and thinking that I could make a deal with the ego that would help the whole world, where the ego would agree, okay, I'm only going to take another year, and then that's it. The ego never keeps its promise, never. If you give the ego a year and says, okay, we agree on another year of giving you another year to try to accomplish what you're doing, when you reach that year, the ego will just keep right on with what it's doing. And you say, whoa, wait a minute, we had a deal. And the ego says, well, you know what, in this last year of making my efforts, I realized that your terms were not on good faith, and your justification was not as valid as you thought it was. So that's why I'm continuing on. It wasn't in total good faith. And you say, well, wait a minute, what are you talking about? And the ego says, well, what are you talking about? And you say, wait a minute, whoa. The ego just keeps on, says, no, not in good faith. And you say, okay, well, wait, let's make another deal. I'm not good with this. And then the battle just keeps going on. I remember last life, I said, ego, I'll give you one more life, that's it. This is the last life I'm giving you. And the ego said, okay, we have a deal. And so I said, okay. And then I found myself reincarnated, and I said, well, wait a minute. You said the last life was the last one. And the ego says, well, you broke your promise. You broke your promise. I said, what do you mean? I didn't break my promise. You broke the promise. The ego says, no. And then you get into this terrible battle. And the ego simply says, you're not keeping your side of the bargain. I said, what do you mean? Yes, I have. He says, no, you're not. And then you get into the discussion. Well, why? Why am I not keeping my side of the bargain? He says, well, you need to look at yourself and find out why you're doing that. And then you start becoming self-reflective. You start being obsessed with looking at what you did wrong. That's not the way. Okay. All this self-reflection is not the way. That's a trick the ego's using, because you say, well, I don't want another life, and I don't want you to keep breaking your promise, ego. So, and the ego claims, well, you broke the promise, not me. You know, the ego says that to you. You're the one that broke the promise. You're the one that has the problem, not me. And so then you start trying to find, well, what did I do wrong? And you become, you know, obsessed with this inward self-reflection of trying to find what you did wrong. But what I'm saying here is very important, is that's not the way. It doesn't work. Because the only problem we have is the severe continuity problem of location and label. That's the only problem we have. And as long as we don't realize that, this problem will continue to drive us into this gloomy self-reflection of, why did I break my promise to the ego? How come the ego didn't keep its promise? I must have done something wrong. Or, no, the ego did something wrong, I'm going to punish the ego. And then you get into this belligerent, horrible mood. All of that is driven by the continuity problem, because you feel like you have to deal with labels and location. And then the ego's got you. Because it can point out infinite but plausible mistakes you make. That the ego says, well, you're not perfect, you need to clean that up. And you think, well, maybe that's the problem. I can't make the ego keep its promise because I I'm not perfect, or something like that. That is what failure is built on. That is what failure is built on. And you know, we've all been there. We're all there, actually, now. Continuity problem with label, name, label, and location. Label and location is the losing situation. And therefore, we have this losing problem. As long as label and location hold us back, we're going to lose to the ego. Lose and lose and lose and lose and lose. Continuity problem. I accept that. That means I have to incorporate label and location into my spiritual practice. Okay? I cannot, without doing that, I'm going to be too scared of the continuity problem, and therefore I'm going to cut the ego too much slack, and I'm going to use its terminology. It's going to be on its terms, and I'm going to have to try and come up with a deal for the ego. And so I have to come up with what kind of deal is going to work, and I'm going to be obsessed with all this, and it's going to get me nowhere. Absolutely nowhere, just spinning my wheels. And frustration builds up. And gloominess builds up. And anger builds up. And depression builds up. And you say, wow, I just don't know how to get out of this. This whole complex builds up. So there's one way out of that. That's right spiritual practice, which addresses only the continuity problem. My only problem is the continuity problem. So when we start out, we have the mood of repentance as the first step. The second step is the practice, the continuity exercise. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. I don't have any other problem. Okay. Then we begin to use location and label as our practice. And that defunds the deal, all deals with the ego. It defunds it. You say, hey, wait a minute. I don't need to make any deal with the ego. This, what I'm doing, is good enough. All I need is a vision of oneness. I don't need to make any deals. And I can have the vision of oneness because I feel that I'm able to have a soft landing into the vision of oneness through the spiritual practice. And then the vision of oneness is the soft landing back into reality. So I have this soft landing going for me, and that's all I need. That's all that I need. But if we don't do this, we're going to fail for sure. And we're going to have another life. And we're going to accept the deal. The deal is another life. That's what the ego will tell you. It'll say one more day, one more year. And when you get to the end of your life, it'll say, well, just one more life. That's what it does. I've been through it. I can tell you it's exactly what it does. It keeps kicking the can down the road. And you keep giving it more time because you're afraid of the continuity problem. That is the entire problem. There is no other problem we have. The continuity problem is the only problem we have. Label and location. We have been trying to uncreate creation, to undo identity, for so long, through label and location, which is perception, that we cannot just immediately dispense with it, not immediately and directly. No, we have to practice. And what the ego does is it tells us, you don't need to practice. The ego says, well, if it's true, you should be able to accept it directly. And if you can't accept it directly, well, it must not be true. The ego trips you up on this. And so it has you slaving away at trying to get direct realization instead of doing the soft landing of right spiritual practice. The greatest teachers in history, all of them have insisted on right spiritual practice as the way. All of them. You name the big heavyweights. You know, not all of them. I don't need to name all of them. There have been many. But for instance, Buddha, Shankara, Anandamayi, Ramana Maharshi, Jesus Christ, all right, who has really given us the most recent testimony in A Course in Miracles, and it's all about you have to practice. He says, listen, reading the curriculum is great. It's the foundation, but without the practice, it won't succeed. He says, directly says that, without the practice, it will not succeed. So all of those great teachers insisted on right spiritual practice. Shankara said, look, you're basically said you have such a severe continuity problem. You're going to have to just take it. You need to spend your entire life in right spiritual practice and just do it. And with that attitude, You probably won't need to spend your whole life. You'll probably succeed in this lifetime. You'll finish. But you have to have that attitude. He made no bones about it whatsoever. All these great teachers said the same thing. It's the ego that says that you should be able to get it without practice. Because the ego knows you have this continuity problem. It knows you're hooked. It doesn't quite understand it, but it knows you have this vulnerability, an addiction to label and location. And so it just plays you for a fool. And of course, we're all lazy. We're all lazy. We all say, I just want to go back to sleep. I'm tired. So I can't, it's too much effort. But you go back into the sleep of horrors. Identity is not sleep. Omnipresence never sleeps. There is no sleep in it. There's no tiredness in omnipresence. Identity is not tired. Identity never gets tired. Identity is ever fresh. It never suffers degradation, stress, breaking down, fatigue, tiredness. The omnipresence of identity is ever fresh. The omnipresent identity of this plant, just as it is ever fresh. The omnipresent identity of this bush, just as it is ever fresh. This plant, just as it is the ever fresh, omnipresent identity. That dirt, just as it is the ever fresh, omnipresent identity. The ever fresh, omnipresent identity is that dirt just as it is. This flower is the ever fresh, omnipresent identity. This flower just as it is the ever fresh, omnipresent identity. So the only way is to tolerate this type of use of language, to hear it, to get used to it, and to tolerate it and to accept it, even though ego is just freaking out. You know, it just says, I'm leaving. Can't stand it, I'm leaving. Don't say anything to the ego. Don't beg it to stay, don't tell it to leave. Don't engage it in any way. Because then, immediately, the ego will engage you in will. How soon does it need to leave? It'll engage you in time. Okay, the practice we're doing here is timeless. We're not making a deal with time. What is omnipresent has nothing to make a deal with. Do we need to make a deal with nothing? What kind of deal do we need to make with nothing? So, spending your time with it, whatever your brothers and sisters who are sharing right spiritual practice, whatever they're using, it's useful to you. From the standpoint of getting used to the terminology, getting used to the way of using language, getting used to no deals, getting used to not addressing the ego, getting used to not addressing time, getting used to that, whatever source you find helpful, that is accustoming yourself to this. So that is your soft landing. It's helping in that. Don't worry if you don't awaken immediately. We're looking for a soft landing. So I've used a lot of teachers. I've listened to a lot of teachers. I've always been listening. My entire life, I've been listening to spiritual teachers and teachings. My entire life. That's basically all I've done, for the most part. But of course, the ego crept in there, and said, "Let's do both. Of course, as it always does. But there's been a continuous stream of spiritual effort. But what I didn't do is I didn't do these real concise, hard-hitting label and location spiritual exercises. And what I find is that in doing those, that is what really defunds the ego at its root. The other stuff is helpful. It leads up to the capacity to do these exercises. It builds a comfort zone and a familiarity zone. Yesterday I was reading Wang Chenpa, and I felt very comfortable with what was being said. And it's said in an incredibly clear way. It's just, wow. It's really stunning. And I made several videos, and I will share those with you. And I preface that with saying that this is intense effort. And you don't want it to drive you back into the ego, the arms of the ego, for sure. So don't get caught by the trap of thinking that if you don't awaken from listening to this, that somehow you weren't practicing properly. That's the ego telling you that. The ego says, well, okay, I'll give you one more practice. If that doesn't succeed, then we're back to time, you know, talking about time and stuff. No. No deals with nothing. There are no deals I need to make with nothing. There are no deals I need to make with time. I use time on my own terms, okay? I'm using time for right spiritual practice. That's the only use of time, right use of time there is. Right use of time, right use of mind. I don't need to make any deals with the ego. I'm not saying that that this is the only time I get to use, no. I'm gonna use some more time on right spiritual practice. So you're not going to just awaken just because you're doing intense practice. First, the complexes need to flee from you. Awakening is already there. Your identity is already there. You're not putting it in place. It's already in place. It's simply that the seeking complex, the deal complex, the hero complex, all these complexes, they will flee. As we defund them, they automatically drop off of their own accord. We don't have to do anything except defund them. So that's what we're doing here. We're relentlessly defunding all of this. So they drop away of their own accord. We don't have to talk about any deal at all. Instead, we give no time to deals at all. That's what defunds. No deal, defunding. We defund by no deals. Defunding by no deals. Deal defunding. We're deal defunding. Label and location, deal defunding. The deal defunding exercises. So, I did several videos with Wang Chenpa's writings, teachings, and it certainly had an effect. But you see, it's a non-linear effect. It's a defunding of all deals with the ego. The ego says, well, where's the deal? There is no deal. We're not making a deal. No deals. So the ego again says, well, put it in a linear way. Put it in a deal that I can examine. Where is the deal that I have to okay it? No, there is no deal. The ego doesn't have to okay a non-deal. There's no deal in place. The vision of oneness is the soft landing. Label and location practice is the soft landing into the vision of oneness, which is the final soft landing. So we don't need to make any deals. We have what works. The ego's out is not in negotiations. We're not in negotiations with the ego anymore. So laziness says, you don't need to do that. You know, it's difficult. What I did was I read it very slowly, and it was very helpful and profound. That is extremely difficult to do, because it interrupts the ego's linear label, location, deal-making agenda. When you read it very slow, the ego is just like, can't tolerate that. Because it's in a rush to get a deal done for more time. And when you're using the language this way, you're not available to it. So it says, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. So the slow form of reading is, I find, the most intense type of practice. And I'm feeling now like, wow, that the difficulty, you know, it's like, can I do it? Good Lord. So the ego is screaming, where's the deal? Come on, where's the deal? You're supposed to be fashioning a better deal for me. The ego says, I'm amenable to it if you just can justify it to me. I'm eager to read the terms of your deal. No deal. There are no terms. There are no terms. There is no deal. There are no terms. Our terminology is for simply the continuity problem. All right? We are entirely focused only on the continuity problem here, which is the resolution, which means, hey God, I need a soft landing. That's it. It's not a deal with God, it's a soft landing. That's not a deal. It's not a deal for time. It's not a deal for anything. It's simply a soft landing. And the ego is, because we're using terms here, but just look at it that way. Look at it that way. Does it seem to take time? It does seem to take time. But you might say it's the only right use of time there is to the soft landing to resolve a continuity problem. So because we're used to time, we will say, okay, we'll use time, but only in this way. It's the only right use of time there is. It's not a deal with time. It's the right use of time. See, a deal would be to say, well, let's use time in the right way and the wrong way a little bit. See, that's a deal. There is no deal. There is no deal. What is omnipresent doesn't need, what can it make a deal with? But the soft landing, because we have a continuity problem, God recognizes our continuity problem. That's it. That's all that's recognized. God only recognizes our continuity problem. Nothing else. And so, all we need to do is recognize we have a continuity problem, label, location, time, right use of time. And then focus on right spiritual exercises. And the ego says, well, you're giving God time. How come you can't give me time? No, we're giving the continuity problem time. We're not giving God time. We're giving the continuity problem time. This is very important. We're giving the soft landing time. What is omnipresent doesn't need any time. What is our true identity is already our true identity. It doesn't need any time. You see, we just need time for the soft landing, but not for our identity, not for reality. The ego will say, well, you need time to establish it. No, we don't need any time to establish what already is. We don't. What already is needs no time for that plant to be what it is. What already is needs no time for this table to be what it is. What already is needs no time for this dirt to be what it is. To be what it is. You see, so in doing the exercises, we're using time, but it's right use of time to free us from the continuity issue with time. It's the only right use of time there is. What already is needs no time for this wall to be what it is. What already is needs no time for this walkway to be what it is. What already is needs no time for this day to be what it already is. What already is needs no time for this tree to be what it already is. This tree as it is already is what it is. This walkway as it is already is what it is. This table as it is already is what it is. This dirt as it is already is what it is. This sky as it is already is as it is. That sun as it is already is as it is. That orange as it is already is as it is. That orange tree as it is already is as it is. That driveway as it is already is as it is. That car as it is already is as it is. That fence as it is already is as it is. The one identity as it is already is as it is. That house as it is already is as it is. That branch as it is already is as it is. That's those clouds, the clouds in the sky as it is already is as it is. This bottle as it is already is as it is. That post as it is already is as it is. This is defunding the ego very powerfully. I'm feeling it. The ego is like pulling up roots and trying to desperately get away. Let that happen. Don't ask, what's going on, ego? What's going on with you? No. Stay in the mood of repentance. No deal. Today's a no deal day. Today is our no deal day. That plant is our no deal plant. This desk is our no-deal desk. This is our no-deal desk. That dirt is no-deal dirt. That dirt as it is no-deal dirt as it is. That driveway as it is a no-deal driveway as it is. That flower is a no-deal flower as it is. That walkway is a no-deal walkway as it is. This cat is a no-deal cat just as it is. that wall, as it is a no-deal wall, as it is. That telephone pole, as it is a no-deal telephone pole, as it is. This day is a no-deal day, as it is. This day, as it is a no-deal day, as it is. This planet is a no-deal planet. This planet, as it is a no-deal planet, as it is. This universe, as it is a no-deal universe, as it is. I am, as I am, dwelling in a no-deal universe, as I am. I, as I am dwelling in a no-deal universe, as I am. This planet, as it is a no-deal planet, as it is. This is having an extreme effect. Again, do not quantify the effect. Do not tabulate it, catalog it, measure it, anything. Just a general statement. It's having an extreme effect. That's it. That's all that's needed. Not even that's needed, but we recognize it. This bird song, as it is a no-deal bird song, as it is. That paver, as it is a no-deal paver, as it is. This wastebasket, as it is a no-deal wastebasket, as it is. This bottle, as it is a no-deal bottle, as it is. This light, this sunlight, as it is a no-deal sunlight, as it is. This air, as it is no-deal, is a no-deal air, as it is. That tree, as it is a no-deal tree, as it is. This life, as it is a no-deal life, as it is. This practice, as it is a no-deal practice, as it is. This house, as it is a no-deal house, as it is. This road, as it is a no-deal road, as it is. This city, as it is a no-deal city, as it is. This countryside, as it is a no-deal countryside, as it is. That mountain, as it is a no-deal mountain, as it is. That car, as it is a no-deal car, as it is. Noise, as it is a no-deal noise, as it is. Now, you'll find when you're doing these exercises that the ego will say, hey, that one that you were just doing before, that was really powerful. What was that one? And that stops you from doing the one you're doing right now. It's a really trick of the ego. It's true, the one that I did before was powerful. So is this one. So is this one. And the ego will say, wait a minute, let's get back to the one you were just doing before. That was working great. when the Holy Spirit shifts it, the Holy Spirit says, okay, that's enough of that one. Let's go over to this one. And the ego says, whoa, wait a minute. This other one was working fine. Why are you changing? Because the ego's trying to stop this new one from taking place. Because that one is digging at a different angle. You see, when you're digging the root out, you go from different angles. You keep shifting the angle. When you're digging a hole, you got to do that, right? When you're trying to get out a real tough root, you kind of go out from this angle, that angle, a lot of different angles until you finally get it out. I've had a lot of practice with that, digging out roots. Sometimes I got older, I had to get some help. The right force and the right leverage is what finally works. You really need to be able to apply, you know, a big final push that, boom, finally pops the last part of that root out. Taken out so many, many, many roots. Physical roots, but now what we're doing is taking out the root of the ego here. We're taking that root out. When I was young, I actually enjoyed the challenge of taking out roots. I was really, oh, there's a root, okay, a root there, I'm gonna get that, okay. All right, you can dig here, saw this, you know, and just you work at it. Today is a no-deal day. Today, just as it is a no-deal day, just as it is. Today is a rootless day. Today, just as it is a rootless day, just as it is. This plant, as it is a rootless plant, just as it is. This table, as it is a rootless table, just as it is. That wall, as it is a rootless wall, just as it is. This sky, just as it is a rootless sky, just as it is. That sun, just as it is a rootless sun, just as it is. That driveway, just as it is a rootless driveway, just as it is. That tree, just as it is a rootless tree, just as it is. That house, as it is a rootless house, just as it is. And you can make it even more profound if you're doing your walking exercises or traveling. The seamless form of exercise. This table, as it is the rootless plant, as it is the rootless walk, just as it is the rootless hedge, just as it is the rootless barbecue, just as it is the rootless tree, just as it is the rootless fence, just as it is. Or you could say, this light is the rootless tree, is the rootless dirt, is the rootless sky, is the rootless planet, is the rootless universe, is the rootless now, is the rootless pebble, is the rootless stone, is the rootless stonework. Okay, do that for him. That orange, just as it is the rootless orange, just as it is. That sky, just as it is the rootless sky, just as it is. This table, as it is the rootless table. This table is the rootless table. So, I forget what I'd said before, but that's fine. You keep your, don't break your stride. You just keep your stride going. When you're practicing, Don't break your stride. If you forget what it was, don't struggle trying to remember it. Do not struggle. Never struggle in that way. The struggle, the focus is keeping your stride. Okay, so keep your stride. So that rootless sky is the rootless astroturf, is the rootless leaf, is the rootless tree, is the rootless table. Is the rootless day, is the rootless no deal day. This is the rootless no deal. So this paver is the rootless no deal paver. That sky is the rootless no deal sky. That car is the rootless deal free car. That house is the rootless deal free house. This day is the rootless deal free day. This planet is the rootless deal free planet. The no-deal planet, the rootless no-deal planet. This universe is the rootless no-deal universe. This table is the rootless no-deal table. This body is the rootless no-deal body. This cat is the rootless no-deal cat. That bird is the rootless no-deal bird. That berry is the rootless no-deal berry. That barbecue is the rootless no-deal barbecue. That mat is the rootless no-deal mat. This post is the rootless no-deal post. This air is the rootless no-deal air. This area is the rootless no-deal area. This camera is the rootless no-deal camera. This breath is the rootless no-deal breath. This life is the rootless no-deal life. This life is the rootless no-deal life. This life is the rootless no-deal life. Soft landing, but can feel the landing. It's a soft landing, yes. Very powerful, these exercises. Now, indebtedness for this, for sure. Jesus Christ, in his great, great teachings and admonitions to practice, especially in the Bible and in the Course in Miracles, both. More recently, A Course in Miracles is very focused on practicing. Okay. Sri Anandamayama, super, super focused on practicing. People said that she's just such a beauty. Oh, you're so beautiful. She's the meanest, toughest teacher there ever was in terms of practice. If people think she's a nice, beautiful lady, no. Total taskmaster. Holy cow. So that her extreme emphasis on that. Totally, very indebted to that. Ramana Maharshi, very indebted to that. Just the stillness, that's all. Total practice. Just showing you. 100%. Just practice the stillness. Okay, very indebted to that. Longchenpa. Very indebted to Longchenpa. As a great mentor of tremendous right use of label and location to point out the rootlessness of it all. Just these shining jewel-like expressions that give me ideas. A wonderful mentor in that way. So those are some of the indebtedness. There's others, of course. All the teachers that have ever been have added to the river of right spiritual practice. All of them. There, you know, so many. The ego wants us to name them all. Say, oh, you're leaving this out, leaving that one out, or leaving that. No, that's not the point. But we all have our teachers that we relate to most effectively. We don't need to relate to all teachers most effectively. That's the ego that is buying time by all this kind of stuff. So whatever your mentors and teachers and helpers are, make sure that you get to make the most of it. This rootless day, abiding in this rootless spaciousness, in this rootless sky, on this rootless planet, in this rootless universe. This rootless universe. This rootless now. This rootless identity. This rootless experience. I am that rootlessness. I am that rootlessness. This is this rootlessness. This is the rootlessness. This is this rootlessness. And the ego say, hey, wait, you didn't name all the teachers. You had some more, you had some more. Is he trying to distract from the practice? That's what it does. So just go right back. This rootless moment is this rootless bottle, is this rootless plant, is this rootless shrub, is this rootless hedge, is this rootless driveway, is this rootless air, is this rootless barbecue, is that rootless hedge, is that rootless tree, is this rootless sky, is this rootless city, is this rootless continent, is this rootless planet, is this rootless galaxy, is this rootless universe, is this rootless flower, is this rootless whiteboard, is this rootless desk, is this rootless table, is this rootless cap, is this rootless light bulb? Is that rootless orange? Is this rootless place? Is that rootless wall? Is this rootless cloudiness? Is this rootless breath? Is this rootless life? Is this rootless identity? Is this rootless identity? Very powerful. Again, the ego is trying to say, why don't you give more accreditation? Do that. Now, the true teachers are not looking for accreditation. They are looking for right spiritual practice. So I probably shouldn't hardly even mention it, you know. Because the ego seizes upon it and says, hey, wait a minute. How come you're not giving me accreditation? Now, how much accreditation do you give to this one and how much to that one? And you're leaving out this one. Well, there's a, you should give a little to that. And the whole thing gets shifted over to the issue of accreditation. Label, location, judgment, relative value. Sucked into that black hole. Just like that. No. This rootless accreditation. this rootless Jesus, this rootless Anandamayama, this rootless Longchenpa, this rootless Ramana Maharshi, this rootless Shankara, this rootless Buddha, this rootless time, this rootless place, this rootless universe, this rootless expression, this rootless spaciousness, this rootless identity, this rootless now, this rootless life, this rootless breath, this no-deal desk, this rootless no-deal desk, just this rootless this rootless this. All right, that's it. Well, let me make a little better soft landing of the ending of it. I was going to be interrupted there, so this rootless ending of the video, this rootless video, this rootless ending, continue your right spiritual practice. That's it. Your rootless right spiritual practice. This is the deal-free day. This day, just as it is. Just as it is. This is the deal-free rootless day, the deal-free rootless clouds. This leaf, just as it is the deal-free rootless leaf, as it is. These stones, just as they are the deal-free rootless stones, just as they are. These are the deal-free rootless stones. Just this, as it is, this, as it is. This is the deal-free rootless palm frond. This is the deal-free rootless plant. This is the deal-free rootless tree. This is the deal-free rootless plant. Just as it is, all of this is the deal-free rootless day, just as it is. This is the deal-free rootless bag of bark, just as it is. This is it. This is the deal-free rootless pole, just as it is. This, as it is the deal-free rootless branch, as it is. This is the deal-free rootless table, as it is. The deal-free rootless screen, as it is. This is the deal-free rootless screen, as it is. This palm plant, as it is the deal-free rootless palm plant, as it is. This rootless, deal-free thermometer, just as it is free from all inside and all outside. This rootless, deal-free leaf, just as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. This deal-free and rootless barbell, just as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. This rootless and deal-free pine cone, just as it is totally free of all inside and all outside. This rootless and deal-free flower, just as it is entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. These rootless and deal-free berries, just as they are entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. Those deal-free and rootless clouds, just as they are entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. This rootless and deal-free orange, just as it is totally free of all insideness and all outsideness. These rootless and deal-free leaves, just as they are totally free of all insideness and all outsideness. This totally rootless and deal-free tire, just as it is completely free of all insideness and all outsideness. This totally rootless and deal-free sweet pea, just as it is completely free of all inside and all outside. This flower, just as it is, this rootless and deal-free flower, just as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. This totally rootless, deal-free kale is entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. This deal-free and totally rootless cabbage, just as it is entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. This completely rootless and deal-free broccoli is, as it is entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. This totally rootless, totally deal-free celery, just as it is totally free of all insideness and all outsideness. This totally rootless and completely deal-free lettuce, just as it is entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. These rootless and deal-free lemons, just as they are, are entirely free of all inside and all outside. This rootless and deal-free garlic, just as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. These totally rootless and deal-free blossoms, just as they are entirely and completely free of any insideness and any outsideness. This perfectly rootless free and deal-free palm tree, just as it is completely free of all inside and all outside. This totally rootless and deal-free cabbage. Just as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. This deal-free and totally rootless flower, as it is completely free of all inside and all outside. This rootless light, this deal-free light, this light as it is completely free of all inside and all outside. This rootless and deal-free leaf, as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. These rootless stones, these deal-free stones, just as they are completely free of all insideness and all outsideness. This deal-free rootless mat, just as it is entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. Without any roots, without any deals, this tree, just as it is entirely free of all insideness and all outsideness. And this day, being totally rootless and totally deal-free, this rootless and deal-free day, just as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. This rootless, deal-free table, just as it is entirely free of all inside and all outside. This rootless, deal-free stone, just as it is entirely free of any inside and any outside. And this rootless and deal-free bottle, just as it is, stands without any inside and any outside. Those rootless and deal-free flowers, just as they are completely free of insideness and outsideness.